Hello everyone, my name is Ioanna Zafiriou and I'm a teacher of English based in Greece. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a word cloud using WordArt Creator. First, go to the website wordart.com and click Sign Up at the top right-hand corner of the screen. In the following screen, choose a username, enter your email, and create a password. Then check that you have read and accept the terms of service and the privacy policy, and whether you would like to be kept updated on WordArt news and offers. Fill in the captcha and click on Sign Up. You can also sign up using your Facebook, Google, or Twitter account. As I already have an account, I'll just sign into my account by clicking Login. Let's have a look around. At the top of the page, we've got several tabs. The gallery, where you can explore other users' word clouds. You can also search by topic. Pricing packs and plans for additional features, such as high-quality downloads. The community, with many useful features such as tutorials, forums, a blog, and many more. But now I'm going to go to my WordArt to check out my own word clouds, the ones I have created so far. I'm going to show you some just to give you an idea of what you can do using WordArt. Let's have a look. This one is about learning English. This one is about Big Ben. A first aid one. A Happy New Year one. One with mathematical symbols. A body language one. And another one. Several on food and drink. And these are just some of the word clouds I have already created. Let's get started and create our first word cloud. I'll make a body language word cloud. I'll hit back first and return to the preview screen. First, I'll click Create over here. Next, I'll give a name to my word cloud. Body language. Then I'll start building my word cloud by entering words into the generator. I can either type in the words or import them from a document. I can add or remove words, and I can move them up and down. Once I've entered the words, there are other options. I can edit their size, their color, angle, and font. There are even more options over here. For example, whether I want the words to be repeated, be maximized, and an option about the use of links. In our example, I'm going to fill in the blanks as following. Wave, shake, hands, shrug your shoulders, point your finger, fold your arms, etc. As you can see, you can also use phrases, not just single words. Next, I'm going to select the shape for my word cloud. You can choose from the existing shapes, or you can add your own with add image. I highly recommend using an image or clip art with a strong contrast of light and dark. This will work best and you'll get a better looking word cloud. On the left, you can see many different categories to choose from. Let's have a look. We really are spoiled for choice. These might actually work, but I'd rather use an image from my computer. Okay. Underneath, we see the fonts we can use, and some of them give you more options, such as regular, italic, bold, and many more. Further down, we've got the layout. That is the layout that our word cloud will have. And right below that is the style with more options available. You don't have to edit every single feature, of course, but you can if you wish to. Once you're done, click on Visualize to get your word cloud. Of course, you can change any feature, hit Visualize again, and get a different cloud altogether. You can see that as I hover over it, the words stand out. Once I'm all set and happy with it, I can either download my word cloud as an image or share it online. I've got several sharing options. I can share it on Facebook, Twitter, send it to my email, get the link to share it wherever I want, or embed it on a web page. Of course, I have to make it public first. Let's see. For instance, to download it as an image, I can either choose between standard PNG or standard JPEG. The rest of the options are for paid plans, so I'll just choose standard JPEG. Click OK. I get a preview and it has been saved to my downloads. So, good luck with your creations. Bye!